Hello dear children, this is my second video on units of measurement. In my previous class, I have taught you the first unit, that is units of length. Today we will read the second one, that is units of mass. So in order to know what are the units of mass, first we should know what mass is. The weight of an object is called mass. So the units are used to measure the weight of an object. If we have to know what is the weight of a certain object, suppose a soap or a box. So these are of small weights. So these units are calculated in grams. And we should know 1 gram is equals to 1 upon 1000 kg. Now next is kilograms. Kilograms is used to measure larger masses that have more weight. And 1 kg is equals to 1000 grams. So suppose if we have to measure the weight of 1 kg rice, that is kg. So we used to measure more weight amounts in kg. Now this is a table which I have shown you earlier in the units of length also. The table is the same, but here in between there is grams, not meter, and here it is decagram, hectogram and kilogram, and here it is decigram, centigram and milligram. As I told you earlier that the units on the left of grams are bigger units and the units on right of grams are smaller units. It is similar to the table that we made in units of length. Now as we move further from a larger unit to a smaller unit, we always multiply it by 10. And whenever we move from a smaller unit to a larger unit backwards, we always divide by 10 at each step. Now, we will use this table to solve our conversions. So let's start with question number 1. Convert the following. A. 19 kg into grams. Here, we have to convert kg into grams. So how many steps we will move forward? That is 1, 2, 3. We will move 3 steps ahead. So we will multiply it by 1000. So first we will take the basic, that is 1 kg is equal to 1000 grams. Now we will find the grams in 19 kg, that is 19 kg is equals to 19 into 1000, that is 19,000 grams. Now we move to question number B. 2 decigrams into milligrams. Here decigram is this and we have to move till where? 1, 2 milligrams. So we will move 2 steps ahead. So for moving 2 steps ahead, we will multiply it by 100. That is 1 decigram is equals to 100 milligrams. And 2 decigrams will have more milligrams. So 2 into 100, that is 200 milligrams. Now we will solve the questions where we have to go backwards. Question number C. 1349 grams into kg and grams. Here we have to go backwards 3 steps. 1, 2, 3. So 1 gram is equals to 1 upon 1000 kg. Therefore, 1349 grams will be multiplied by 1 upon 1000, that is 1349 upon 1000 kg. Now, here we have to divide it by 1000. So, 3 zeros means 3 digits from the right will form the G, that is grams, and the leftover 1 will form the kg. So, 1 kg and 349 grams. Now question number D. 500 decigram into decagram. So decigram is here and we have to move 2 steps backwards, that is 1, 2. So we will divide it by 10 and 10, that is 100. So 1 decigram is equals to 1 upon 100 decagram. Therefore 500 decigrams will have more decagram, that is 500 multiplied by 1 upon 100, that is 500 upon 100 decagram is equals to 5 decagram, because these two zeros will be cut from these two zeros. Now E part 7 kg into hectogram. So from kg to hectogram we will move one step forward. That means we will multiply it by 10. So 1 kg is equals to 10 hectograms, and 7 kg will have more hectograms, that is 7 into 10 hectograms, that is 70 hectograms is our answer. Now F, 5 grams into milligrams. So we will go 1, 2, 3. 3 times forward means we will multiply it by 10, 10, 10, that is 1000. 1 gram is equals to 1000 milligrams, therefore 5 grams will have more milligrams, that is 5 multiply 1000 milligrams, 5000 milligrams. Now G, 4 kg, 523 grams into grams. Here we have to convert both these into grams. As you can see here, kg we have to convert into grams, but this grams is already converted into grams. So 1 kg is equal to 1000 grams. 4 kg will have more number of grams, that is 4 multiply 1000, 4000 grams. Now we will convert these two grams by adding these two in grams. 4 kg can be written as 4000 grams, and 523 is already in grams, so it will be copied same here as it is. We will add these two grams and we will get our obtained answer, that is 4523 grams. I hope you have understood various conversions by this table. Now we will move forward for today's worksheet. So this is our second worksheet on units of measurement. Question number 1. Do the following conversions: A, 512 kg into grams, B, 2000 grams into hectograms, C, 13,178 grams into kilograms and grams, D, 10 kg 526 grams into grams, E, 13,000 milligrams into centigrams. I hope you do these questions in your copy, and we will meet you in the next video on measurements again. Thank you.